try and build us a trebuchet. We don't know much about it. We only know about that pumpkin chunk and stuff with the air cannons.
Yeah.
So we want to toss something clear across the cornfield. We're going to go over to England. We're going to ask some doctoral type named Jared T. Hinkle. He's going to help us out. Well, you got anything to say? Best that sums it up.
Yep.
We're from America. We're the Jerry Hinkle type.
Looks like they got out again. Be gone!
You didn't catch
it? Oh, hello. I didn't see you there. Welcome to Medieval Marvels. I'm your host, Dr. Jared T. Hinkle. Today we will be discussing the trebuchet. The trebuchet was a medieval siege weapon used to break down the barricades of heavily barricaded castles in medieval times. Now, in order to launch these projectiles, what is that bloody racket?
Stay put, you mongrel! You'll have to excuse me, ladies and gentlemen. I've been experimenting on some Americans, and sometimes they get out of their cages. You know how it is, I'm sure. Now, as I was saying before I was so rudely interrupted, the trebuchet employs a counterweight mechanism in order to launch the projectiles. Now, the weight of the counterweight, when compared to the weight of the projectile, must be of a 100-to-1 ratio. The throwing arm is composed of two portions, divided by the pivot point. Now, the length of the arm that is connected to the sling must be 4 times longer than the section of the arm that is connected to the counterweight. The sling itself must be 3/4 the length of the throwing section of the throwing arm. A firing pin is used to unleash the force of the counterweight and launch the projectile forward.
No, hold on there, doctor. I think we're gonna be here done.
Right, if you must. A word of caution, though, my friends. I must remind you. Never mind, just go do whatever you want.
Okey-dokey.
Bloody Americans.
Get out!
Yeah, they're that dumb.
Tried just about everything, but we can't do a trip. Willis, knock it off!
Jeez.
What are you doing? Anyway, now my compatriots are messing us up. We can't get this thing to run like it's supposed to. Now that Dr. Tefella, he helped us out as best he could. Will you stop, darn it? Okay, that doctor fella, he really helped us out, so I just want to give my hats off and say thanks to him. No matter how hard we tried, though, we could not get this trebuchet shoot like that English type or that French type.
Why are you back in my office? Did you not see the do not disturb sign?
That sign's in English. We only speak American.
They're practically the same language, but whatever. What? How may I help you?
Well, our trebuchet, it don't work.
Why? What do you mean? It does not work.
Well, you can demonstrate, I think.
No, I don't think he has any intention on demonstrating anything.
Alright, well, he shoots straight up into the air.
Well, perhaps you should try lengthening the sling.
Think that'll fix it?
It might.
Alright, well, thank you, Mr. Dr. Professor Dingy-Majiggy. We know English now, and we know how to fix a trebuchet.
Yes, you're very welcome. Now, please, I request you take your absence.
Okay, buddy. Back to America.
Sorry guys, wrong clip. I'll get that fixed.
We're assuming an ideal angle. Also, we're looking for gravity, which is 10 meters per second squared. Now, after doing all of these computations, our velocity is 8.77 meters per second.
What are you doing?
That's blue.
My God!
Okay.
Exactly. Keep going on then.
But now that we have our velocity, a square has for some odd reason. Now, what we need to find is our kinetic energy. Thanks to our range equation here, we now know that kinetic energy is equal to 1/2 times our mass times our velocity. Erase that. Squared. But now, our kinetic energy, the drum roll please, after all the computations, danke, is 38.45 joules. Now, all we need to do is do our potential energy. Actually, no. Hardik, you're messing me up! Was ist das? Oh my god! My colleagues are crazy! I don't know why I'm going Irish either, but as we go on, now we have our kinetic energy and our potential energy. And for our efficiency, we get a nice big number. At 1.04%. Das Blut, do you have anything to say about this?
Yes, I have something to say about this.